The paparazzi, I feel like especially if you're a millennial and grew up in that kind of like reality TV, celebrity obsessed Y2K era, we know the paparazzi for being people who hunt down celebrities, fighting and arguing amongst themselves to get the best shot of like, I don't know, Paris Hilton getting out of a car or Taylor Swift walking to a car, the Kardashians eating salad, I don't know. But what if I told you that a very big chunk of those paparazzi candid pictures were actually planned and staged by the celebrities themselves? And what once used to be a very interesting and candid look into a celebrity's real life is now actually not that much different from what you see on that celebrity's Instagram. Today I want to take a look at a weird obsession of mine, which is staged celebrity paparazzi shots. Who's done them? Who's been caught doing them? And why they do them at all? Let's start off with one of my favorite staged photography paparazzi shots ever, other than the Hillary Duff laughing at oranges, whatever that was about. This is Heidi Montag, or Heidi Pratt. She became famous from the reality TV series The Hills, one of the best programs of all time. But she kind of became more infamous for other things, including her controversial boyfriend, now husband, her choice in cosmetic procedures, and also her interesting music career. Love it or hate it, her music is good pop music. I'm gonna stand up for her on this one. But as The Hills and her kind of reality stardom started to come to an end, her and her husband started this strange kind of like series of staged paparazzi shots. I love these shots, they're so shameless and clearly being used as an advertising loophole to promote brands without following FTC guidelines. But my all-time favorite has to be the shot of Heidi sitting on a random chair on a public footpath, dressed like an early 2000s pop singer, crying over the negative reviews of her single Higher back in 2008. In this picture, she's sitting on a chair, pretending to cry. She's now standing up in this one, all woe is me, with her CD in her hand. This is just so fake. It's so obvious and so shameless at the same time. Like, I absolutely love it. She can't have honestly did this thinking that people be like, oh my God, she's, you know, she's distraught about these reviews out on her public chair. Most recently, Heidi has been Heidi has been pictured out in public eating a raw bison heart from a Ziploc bag, which I've obviously censored here because it kind of made me feel sick. But Heidi is actually very open about staging these photographs. She's very open about finding paparazzi or calling them to herself or going to areas where she knows they're gonna be and arranging what she kind of acts like is a seasonal photo shoot.
We're gonna start doing a little holiday shopping, and of course, I need to call the paparazzi, so I'm going to do my paparazzi holiday photo setup. Good. Finally found Fern! We found each other. Perfect, I just got here.
How's it going?
So, I thought some good pap shots would be by the tree, and yeah, then I was gonna get some bags, like maybe just buy like one thing.
Sure, yeah, stores, yeah.
Just so it looks like
you're doing a holiday shopping kind of thing.
Exactly. So how do we do, Fern?
Good.
Did I look like a celebrity?
Obviously, you always do.
All right, great. Thanks. Great answer.
So, I mean, there's confirmation that celebrities do this. So it does seem like reality stars in particular arrange these kind of photo shoots for attention and to kind of stay relevant. I think with reality stars, once their season is done, before the next season starts, they have a very short window to kind of make sure they remain relevant and people still remember who they are and don't get bored of them. So it kind of makes sense for reality stars to use the paparazzi shots for publicity purposes. But they're not alone. A lot of Hollywood A-listers actually do this as well. For example, Kellan Lutz, who at the time of this interesting, not too obvious, fake paparazzi shot, was kind of an A-lister. He started his career as a model, but really rose to fame in like the Twilight saga. And I'll be honest, I recognize his image because I was a little bit obsessed with him at the time. And I remember thinking, oh my God, oh, look at him playing with dogs and reading a book up a tree. He must be like this gentle giant that's cast in these like action roles, but that's not really who he is. He's soft at heart, you know? And that's exactly what, according to some media outlets, this staged paparazzi shot wants you to think. Here is the alleged story behind this photo shoot. Whilst Kellan Lutz's career seemed to be going pretty great on the surface with this breakout role in Twilight. His agents were trying to give him a softer image because at the time, the best role you can get was in a romantic comedy, in a rom-com. They could really propel you to superstardom. So his agents were like, we need to show this softer side of him, that he can play a romantic role, that he is a romantic person, that is not just like this action figure who fights, this cold vampire type person. So like, let's get him reading a book and playing with dogs and show this softer, caring side of him in hopes that he'll become like a rom-com staple. And it kind of worked. He kind of starred in two rom-coms. One was called A Warrior's Heart and the other one was called Love, Wedding, Marriage. That's a shit name for a film, isn't it? Then after, nothing really happened, and the rumors are that he became kind of difficult to work with despite being kind of less than a B-lister. He demanded these crazy amounts of money, kept telling people he was going to win an Oscar one day, and despite this weird staged paparazzi photo shoot, it just led to him starring in a number of very unsuccessful films. But when I look at this now, I'm just like, where are the dogs? Who's watching the dogs? Are the dogs okay? Are they tied to that tree? It didn't look like they're tied to the tree. Where are they? You're not watching them properly. You're reading a book. He now looks irresponsible to me. Now, here's a clip where we get to see the staged paparazzi in action with Hailey Bieber, supposedly. Hailey Bieber seems to have an interesting relationship with the paparazzi. There's like compilations of her embarrassing moments, worst bits with the paps, videos that claim she's acting up for the paparazzi. But we've also seen several videos of her on her own and also with her husband, Justin Bieber, communicating with paparazzi and kind of directing these shots. This one of Hailey Bieber actually went pretty viral, where she seems to get out of her car, do a bit of a pose for a paparazzi guy, and then gets back in her car, almost like directing and producing this little shot. Then this one of Hailey and Justin is even clearer that they're just working with the paparazzi. They literally get out of a car, hold hands, walk down the street, turn around and get straight back in the car, going nowhere. Just an opportunity to get photographed. Now, here's what I will say. I do feel like Hailey Bieber gets ripped into a fair amount online for various reasons. Being called fake and being called a mean girl seems to be the main ones whilst I was doing this research and looking at the comments and other people's opinions in these staged paparazzi videos. But in her defense, or, you know, to give a different perspective to this, her herself and Justin Bieber have both talked about how actually terrifying they find paparazzi and being followed by the paps are on a daily basis. I actually believe there's even a video, I don't know if it's real or not, but what sounds like Justin Bieber calling LA police, reporting paparazzi for basically dangerously following his car, putting himself and other people at risk. Does it surprise me? Do I think that sometimes this is just like an ultimatum? Like, we could either be hounded by paparazzi all day, have them following us to every location, or we can spend literally 1 or 2 minutes giving them exactly what they want, getting their shots, they get their money, they get to license it, we get left alone. What would you do? I think I'd do that. I think I'd be like, you know what, guys, you have 2 minutes, get your pictures of me, then you have to leave me alone. I'm not saying that's definitely what they do. I think there is a sense of, you know, trying to remain relevant. But it did make me think, especially as we know celebrities do work with the paparazzi quite closely. It's a well-oiled machine, and some celebrities just have to get caught, like Hailey Bieber, and some don't. There's actually rumors that the Kardashian Jenners have purposely hired their own paparazzi guy. It's apparently a well-known fact. They hire him to follow them, but honestly, for a reason I think is kind of clever. So Reddit user Mechtild posted a super interesting forum, whatever it's called, on the Keeping Up with the Kardashians subreddit. So back in 2018 to 2019, the Kardashians and the Jenners were kind of getting into a bit of legal trouble with the paparazzi. Not only them, but like the thousands of fan pages dedicated to the family as well, because they were taking these paparazzi pictures, posting them on the fan accounts and their own personal accounts. Not only that, but they were being edited. People were making like these fan edits of them, but what everybody failed to realize is that paparazzi shots are licensed. You need to pay money to use them and publish them. So the paparazzi who took these pictures were reporting these pages, taking legal action against the Kardashians, threatening to sue. A lot of these fan pages were being taken down completely. Khloe Kardashian actually once tweeted to a fan who asked her, you know, when are we going to see this Versace look? She says, I have to license some of the images first. A paparazzi sued me in the past for reposting an image of myself, so now it just takes me a little longer because I have to go and license the images, they don't get my money. It makes no sense. I kind of get that. I'm not being funny, but if you're the subject of the picture and the image has been taken without your permission, I guess in public though, that's not a thing, right? don't know. Kim Kardashian also tweeted, I hate that the paparazzi agencies get all the fan accounts shut down. We had to think of something, maybe start our own agency and let all the fans post whatever the fuck they want. Let me brainstorm with the family. The next year she tweeted, by the way, since the paparazzi agencies won't allow the fans to repost, all of my pics are taken by my own photographer and you guys can post whatever you want. I think that's kind of genius. So not only do the Kardashians get their own personal paparazzi guy, so they can license the pictures and get some of the money. I believe they take about 60%, which we'll come on to in a minute. But people are constantly posting pictures of them because they can, without any repercussions. Later in the Reddit posts, they have a segment from Splash News, which says, a Sydney paparazzo has lifted the lid on her secret arrangement with the paparazzi agency, referring to Kim Kardashian. Jaden Seyfarth, 20, claims that Kardashian West tips Splash photographers off to her whereabouts and in return gets a percentage of what they make on sales of her image. She selects the pictures and they are photoshopped. It's common knowledge over here. Every single pap knows. She gives Splash the tip, then takes 60% of the money. A former Splash photographer who did not want to be named confirms Seyfarth's claims, but says the percentage Kim Kardashian takes is actually about 40%. I mean, it sounds like the perfect partnership, to be honest with you. And I kind of get, like, if people are going to be hounding you and taking pictures, why would you not monetize that? Why would you not be like, you know what, guys, if I tell you where I'm going to be, let's make money from this. If it's going to happen anyway, you may as well be making money from it. This is another one of my favorite ones, right? This is Lucy Hale goes to Target and puts on mascara. And this is something that was really, really popular. Another example of a celebrity avoiding disclosing an endorsement deal. Here is Lucy Hale coming out of a Target, reaching for her Maybelline Great Lash Limited Edition Designer Mascara. This is so obviously staged, it's actually hilarious and kind of feels like the early days of the influencer. She's very clearly just reaching for this one product, showing the packaging, showing the label, showing the name, showing the product, and then she sits in her car and uses it. I don't think celebrities, when they're being followed by the paparazzi, you know, not wanting it to happen, take time to redo their makeup. I don't know, it's just very weird. Also, this one of Kendall Jenner kind of went viral as a kind of undisclosed sponsorship with Coca-Cola. I believe the new flavor was something like peach vanilla or something weird like that. She goes into this shop, this bodega, and she buys a new Coke and she's in a matching dress, clearly showing the Coca-Cola label. This feels like an advert. This feels very much like she's advertising Coca-Cola despite having a brand deal with Pepsi. Coca-Cola were actually reached out to and they said, we've not paid her a penny, but they like the pictures, basically. Sometimes celebrities just know how to match a drink to their outfit, I guess. I don't know. We talked about it briefly, but why do celebrities do this? Let's take the example of Rihanna and ASAP Rocky announcing Rihanna's pregnancy to the world. So she invited her favorite pap, her favorite photographer, Miles Diggs, to take these exclusive pictures of her with her belly out in Harlem, I believe it was. And she reached out to Miles Diggs herself because she wanted to have control of the announcement, the narrative, how she looked, how her pregnancy was going to be announced on her terms and not some random man hiding in a bush. Miles Diggs is actually known as celebrity's favorite paparazzo because of his more respectful approach to what he does. He doesn't hound, he doesn't shout at them, he doesn't get in their faces. He asks permission before he takes pictures of the celebrities, and if they say no, he doesn't take a picture. And he ends up getting these amazing shots of celebrities. It's not them coming out of the gym in tracksuits or without any makeup on. His images are a mix of paparazzi shots and just editorial. And his pictures look so professional in some cases that a lot of people think that they are all staged, which they are not. He just says he has now grown this rapport with celebrities that when they see him, they do pose for him. They will keep walking, but they know who he is. They know they're gonna get a good picture. They allow him to take his time, shooting on manual, getting the right lighting, getting the right angle. Miles Diggs has also taken numerous candid shots of Rihanna, which she clearly loved and led to her asking him to be the official photographer in these paparazzi style pictures for her pregnancy announcement. He says the mindset surrounding paparazzi has completely changed. Celebrities understand that it benefits them. They've got their social media, a full-time photographer following them around at times. If these images are going to live in magazines, blogs, television, and be printed around the world, there's no reason not to make sure they are as flattering as possible. And I think that's what makes him different, is he is a photographer. And that's not to say say that paparazzi aren't, but there's not much art that goes into it, whereas he really sees his job as taking portraits. And I find that super interesting. Overall, it does seem like those early days of catching the Hiltons coming out of cars wearing short skirts, or men up trees reading books, are long gone. They're long gone. Purely because of the rise of social media and these looks into the everyday lives of celebrities are no longer a rare sight. We see more on their social media than we do looking at Hello magazine or whatever fucks around nowadays, I don't know. So paparazzi have no choice really but to work alongside celebrities under their conditions in sometimes these highly curated, often photoshopped paparazzi style shots. So these real looks into the lives of celebrities often aren't that really real at all. And even if these pictures aren't photoshopped, they're posed, and we know how much posing can make a huge difference in the way somebody looks. I find it interesting. I'd love to know what you would do. If you were a celebrity, would you give the paparazzi what they want for a more relaxing day without being followed everywhere? Or would you just kind of like let them do their thing and have them follow you everywhere? Let me know in the comments, because I think I know what I'd do. I'd rather have a relaxing day and just give them 2 minutes of my time. Maybe even make some money from it. Why not? You can watch the whole Instagram versus reality playlist here. Some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.